Ontario College of Teachers. Great teaching.
I did well in school. It was really important to me to do well, but the way I thought about school was that you went and did what your teachers told you to do so you could get A's, you could get high marks, your, you know, parents would be happy kind of thing. But I didn't necessarily want to do my best because I was interested in what I was learning all of the time. For me, it was important to be like the kinds of teachers that I did have throughout school who let me direct what I was learning. I might ask a question if they seem stuck that helps them kind of get to the next question. What I'm not trying to do is give them questions that they have to give me a specific answer to. When they seek their own path through that and get feedback along the way, I think that leads to more meaningful learning.
Being able to be in an engaging classroom, it makes you like not scared to ask questions and you're not shy to speak out about your own opinions. At first, I was really scared to ask questions and like speak out in class, but like nowadays, if I go to any workshop outside of school, I'm not scared to raise my hand. Even in a learning environment, that might be different.
The early learners in grade 1-2s are studying habitats. I like to take what they're learning in their science class and integrate it with technology when they come into the lab. What I had done was I had taken a little circuit that had a photoresistor in it. I put it into a bag and I asked them to pretend it was an animal.
Can you tell me about this?
Yes. I often try to imagine what they're going to say and then have it do not that thing, because that surprise, that, oh wait a minute, that wasn't supposed to happen, that's a great moment for learning. They listen, they watch. Some of them are like, oh wait a minute, it must have something to do with the light. And at that moment, then we can go back to talking about habitat. So why do animals need a shelter? And then from that moment, well, let's design a shelter for this robot. So that's the connection from me pretending something to the science, to the technology, and then back again, tying it back to vocabulary and concepts within science and technology that I'm trying to get at.
Because she is so excited about what she's doing, I think that the kids remember it a lot too, and I think that that comes to a personality thing as well. I mean, not everybody is excited about what they're teaching, and Beth is somebody who is always excited about what she's doing. Today in our school, Beth was talking about engineers and she's wearing a dress with all these women engineers all over it, and she sewed that herself. She brings her passion to her teaching and you don't get that everywhere. She wants everyone to feel how she feels about science, and so she tries to connect everyone in that way.
I think a lot of my students have the ability to change the world and that they will change the world. Before they can do that, they have to feel that they are able to. Their ability to recognize something that they want to change about a situation and go through the process of thinking of possible solutions, trying solutions, weathering things when they don't go as expected, and coming through the other side with something that did make a difference is really important.
Learn more at oct.ca.